So what happens here is that we write down four equal factors. 1 plus x over 4 times 1 plus x over 4 times 1 plus x over 4 times 1 plus x over 4. And then we look what this is going to turn into. For the first box, we need everything that has no x whatsoever. This is just 1 times 1 times 1 times 1. Anything else would have an x in it. So this becomes 1. For the next box, we need everything that has precisely 1 x in it. For instance, x over 4 times 1 times 1 times 1. 1 times x over 4 times 1 times 1. 1 times 1 times x over 4 times 1. And there's the fourth one, 1 times 1 times 1 times x over 4. We get 4 of these. 4 times x over 4, which is 1 times x. For x squared, we have x from the first two parentheses, but 1 from parenthesis number 3 and parenthesis number 4. X from the first, 1 from the second, x from the third, 1 from the fourth. Or x from the first, 1 from the second, 1 from the third, and x from the fourth. Or 1 from the first, x from the second, x from the third, 1 from the fourth, 1 from the first, x from the second, 1 from the third, and x from the fourth. And the final one, 1 from the first, 1 from the second, x from the third, x from the fourth. 6 options to form something that contains x squared. 6 times x over 4 times x over 4. We can cancel a factor of 2, which leaves us with 3 over 8. To get x to the third power, we need to pick x from 3 parentheses and 1 from the other. We can pick x from the first 3 parentheses and the 1 from the last, or x from parenthesis number 1, number 2, the 1 from the third, x from the last, x from the first parenthesis, 1 from the second, x from the third, x from the fourth, and 1 from the first, x from the second, x from the third, x from the fourth. So 4 ways of doing this, 4 times x over 4 times x over 4 times x over 4, which leaves us with x to the third power over 16. 1 over 16. And the final one, we need 4 factors of x. We have to pick this, and this, and this, and this. That's it. Only one option for doing that. Which leaves us with x over 4 times x over 4 times x over 4 times x over 4. X to the fourth power divided by 256. 1 over 256. So this is a crude approximation to the exponential function. And we find a way of expressing this with powers of x, the beginning of a power series. Let me restate the general equation for the exponential function again. E to the power of x is the limit as n goes to infinity of 1 plus x over n to the power of n. We have now looked at the special case of n equals 4. Hopefully you can imagine that this also works out for 40 or 400, 4000, 4 billion, for whichever number. And the result is it's 1 plus x, we have that already, 1 plus 1x plus x squared over 2. You see, we're close. 4 over 8 would be 1 half. We've got 3 over 8 with that 4 here. Plus x to the third power over 6 plus x to the fourth power over 24 plus and so on up to infinity. To prove this, you need a better method than we have used here. You need binomial coefficients, but hopefully you get the idea where this power series comes from. And actually, it turns out that this 6 is the factorial of 3, this 24 is the factorial of 4, and so on. So the general term would be x to the power of n divided by n factorial. This also gives us a way of computing e itself. E equals e to the power of 1. So we simply set x to 1, which means e equals 1 plus 1 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 6 plus 1 over 24 plus and so on up to infinity. And now you can see how efficient this power series is. 1 plus 1, so we have 2 already, plus 1 half is 2.5 plus 1 over 6 equals 2.6. You see, we're getting pretty quickly pretty close to 2.71 something. So if you actually want to compute Euler's number or the exponential function, you're using this power series.